and all the people who have gathered here on the 22nd user interaction meet. Though the program started in 1990, well, we should have crossed the 25 years of user interaction meet. We are on the 22nd. Maybe it shows in few years we did not do it. But it's very heartening to see that the user interaction meet today has really taken great strides, and also as we just saw from the kind of outputs and products that have been released by NRSC, the usage has tremendously increased. Now, in terms of the ISRO programs itself, that I was mentioning, probably last couple of years we have not had any new addition, but that is going to be more than made up this year, because we are going to have at least 4 missions. One is on the RESAT, our resource activate in the scatterometer, which is stopped functioning, that is going to be replaced. Then we also have the INSAT 3D repeat mission, which is going to add to our ability to provide both for weather monitoring and other various activities that we are doing on this. And part of that 2C, which is also going to be available. We have approved this year a program for improving the CartoSat 1 capabilities with 1.25 meter resolution and including multispectral in that system. So one of the important stereo data sets that we have been getting from CartoSat 1 will get a big fillip once this new mission comes up. Of course, we have to wait for a few years before that mission comes up. In terms of the usage of the data and the way the application activities have taken off, it has really made very rapid strides, because last year we had, with the current government's insistence on using the space technology and its tools in its activities of monitoring, planning. Today we have more than about 160 odd projects with about 60 central government departments, apart from all the states where the activities have been going on. And with our ability to provide not only remote sensing data but also the navigation input, both from Gagan and regional navigation satellite, which we have completed the 5th one very recently, and by end of March we will be completing the constellation. The importance of getting the positioning information without resorting to differential GPS mode, and these positioning information being obtained at a very significantly lower cost, will make a major impact in the way the geospatial activities is going to happen in the country. Today, few of the very important activities which have gone on, whether it is with respect to the Ministry of Culture or whether it is with respect to the Ministry of Post, Department of Post, where the UIM, along with this geospatial crowdsourcing and asset creation activities, has really made a big impact. And the Department of Culture is trying to bring in even the ease of doing business on the heritage sites. And also, as pointed out by Dr. Sarwar, the government is making use of UIM capabilities in monitoring on a regular basis. We have been trying to improve the availability of this data. One of the important developments that have happened in the recent past is on the prices of the products itself. We have now reduced practically more than 50% on all products, and in some of the products it has gone down to 30% of the original price. So with this significant reduction, the availability of the data, as pointed out, is practically with a very small turnaround time. And in addition to this, we are also looking at possibility of making the data free. Today, with 2 years gap, the data is available free. We are looking at reducing this 2-year period to probably about 6 months. So in which case, 6-month-old data you can get free. Very soon, the decisions on this will be made and announced. So with this, the availability of data for various activities is going to have a significant difference. And also it was pointed out that we are setting up mechanisms where all this data, both the current data from our own sources plus whatever is internationally available, all this data plus NICE's output, what he showed, many of these can be used for very significant R&D activities and bringing in new solutions, both the academic institutions and also even the private operators can make use of this data and provide newer solutions to these various problems. And to facilitate that, we are also looking at mechanisms like in JD MATLAB, where the data plus systems for operating and number crunching and place for working will be available to, whether it is for vendors or for even academic institution people. So we are trying to set up places where such activities can be done. This also very soon you will hear about the announcements on these things. The importance of remote sensing data plus weather data and also the data that is coming from various wavelengths including microwave is making a very big impact. And today we are having our resource set as well as RISAT data which is available, and we have also finalized on the programs which will ensure continuity of this data on various resolutions, and with a progressively improved resolution this data will be available and ensuring both the continuity as well as the accuracy of the information is one of the key aspects. And by enabling BOAN on a big way, we are trying to make this data available over the entire country by setting up multiple nodes and also enabling this BOAN services available to, whether it is to the states or any of the central government agencies where they want to host the basic data available for their usage. So this also has been in progress, and you heard already the railways, for example, we have already provided a node and where they can make use of all the BOAN data set and the BOAN update at a location within their premises. Similar thing is also going to be done for all the states, whoever is interested in making use of that. And beyond that, the key thing that we are looking at is more and more academic institutions and the vendors trying to find solutions to the problems by making use of these data sets. Towards this, whatever facilities are required and whatever enabling is required is one of our key priority areas, and I'm sure in the months and years to come you will see the result of what is being attempted. And I take this opportunity to really congratulate National Remote Sensing Agency and Space Application Center and all the regional remote sensing centers for doing a wonderful job of making the data that is being acquired from our own satellites and also from the satellites of international sources to the user community. And we do look forward to the user community's critical assessment of how the services are being provided, what improvements are needed, and how we can improve on what is currently being done. I'm sure next couple of days you will have an opportunity to look at what has been done so far and what is being attempted also is being highlighted. And at the end of these 2 days program, we are looking forward to what new things you are expecting from the agencies like here. Just one more point I wanted to emphasize. One of the new developments that has happened is with respect to the hyperspectral data availability. Recently, we have been able to conduct some hyperspectral airborne activities over more than about 70 sites in the country. The data is being acquired. and once the Department of Defense clears that data, we will make this hyperspectral data also available for various analysis, as well as this will form as a forerunner for the satellite-based hyperspectral imaging system that are going to be built and operated in about 3 to 4 years time from now. So we have been able to get one of the airborne sensors from JPL NASA, and we have fitted on our aircraft, and it has already flown and collected large amount of data, and it's going through the process of clearance. Once that clearance is done, this data also will be available for various R&D activities and enabling us to understand the intricacies of this. When we come up with our own satellite-based hyperspectral, this will serve as a good base. So with this, I once again congratulate NRSC for organizing this and then making things known to the users, and I request all the users to make themselves aware of what is happening and then tell us about what new requirements they have. Wish you all a very happy and productive week. Thank you.